This is Michelangelo's statue of David, one of many of his very impressive works. He also wrote these words that were immediately confirmed by the Spirit within me as being true. I quote, "My unassisted heart is barren clay, which of its native self can nothing feed. Of good and pious works thou art the seed, which quickens only where thou sayest it may. Unless thou showest thine own true way, no man can find it. Father, thou must lead." Psalms 5, 1 through 8. Listen to my words, Lord, consider my lament. Hear my cry for help, my King and my God, for to you I pray. In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning I lay my request before you and wait expectantly. For you are not a God who is pleased with wickedness. With you, evil people are not welcome. The arrogant cannot stand in your presence. You hate all who do wrong. Destroy those who tell lies. The bloodthirsty and deceitful you, Lord, detest. But I, by your great love, can come into your house. In reverence, I bow down toward your holy temple. Lead me, Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make your way straight before me. Psalm 5, 11 and 12. Let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them ever sing for joy. Spread your protection over them. Those who love your name may rejoice in you. Surely, Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with your favor as with a shield. The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose leaves never fail. Psalm 139:16. Your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. Ephesians 2:10. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. 1 Corinthians 3:6 and 7. I planted the seed, Apollos watered it, but God has been making it grow. Neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who makes things grow. Psalm 138:8. The Lord will perfect that which concerneth me. Thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever. 1 Samuel 2:35. I will raise up for myself a faithful priest who will do according to what is in my heart and mind. I will firmly establish his priestly house, and they will minister before my anointed one always. 1 Peter 2:9. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Psalm 57:6 and 7. No one from the east or the west or from the desert can exalt themselves. It is God who judges. He brings one down, he exalts another. Jesus said in Luke 22:31-32, "Simon, Simon, Satan has asked to sift all of you as wheat, but I have prayed for you, Simon, that your faith may not fail, and when you have turned back, strengthen your brothers." Hebrews 7:24-25, "Because Jesus lives forever, he has a permanent priesthood. Therefore, he is able to save completely those who come to God through him, because he always lives to intercede for them." Isaiah 51:12-13, "I, even I, am he who comforts you. Who are you that you fear mere mortals, human beings who are but grass, that you forget the Lord your Maker, who stretches out the heavens and who lays the foundations of the earth?" 1 Peter 5:6-10, "Humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Be alert and of sober mind. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith, because you know that the family of believers throughout the world is undergoing the same kind of sufferings." and the God of all peace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered for a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast. 2 Timothy 1-7. For God has not given us a spirit of timidity, but of power and love and discipline. Numbers 6:24-26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Proverbs 21:31. The horse is made ready for the day of battle, but the victory rests with the Lord. Psalm 18:32-34. It is God that girdeth me with strength and maketh my way perfect. He maketh my feet like hinds' feet and setteth me upon my high places. He teacheth my hands to war so that a bow of steel is broken in my arms. Psalm 33:16-21. No king is saved by the size of his army. No warrior escapes by his great strength. A horse is a vain hope for deliverance. Despite all its great strength, it cannot save. But the eyes of the Lord are on those who fear him, on those who hope in his unfailing love, to deliver them from death and keep them alive in famine. We wait and hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. Psalm 44:6-8. I put no trust in my bow. My sword does not bring me victory. But you give us victory over our enemies. You put our adversaries to shame. In God we make our boast all day long. And we will praise your name forever. Romans 8:1-2. Therefore there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set you free from the law of sin and death. 1 Corinthians 15:56-58. The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm, let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Romans 6:14. For sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace. Romans 6:18. You have been set free from sin and have become slaves to righteousness. John 8:36. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. Colossians 2:8. See to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and empty deception, according to the tradition of men, according to the elementary principles of this world, rather than according to Christ. Romans 15:13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. James 1:4. Let perseverance finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. Psalm 104. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. Philippians 4:4-9. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you.
Father, not only must you lead, but you must also strengthen us so that we can follow.